gets it done.
Hello, ladies and gents. I'm the Rev. This is Indie Contact number 15. And today we're taking a look at Kona, a game made by Parable. And I'm going to be doing an impressions video on this later. But first, I thought, you know, I'll give you guys a little introduction to the game. It's currently $19.99 on USD in the United States on Steam. Check it out. As we get going here, I will see if I can get the voice a little higher for you guys.
Money was so dim, it was customary around these parts to close them.
So this is the very beginning of the game. And also today, if you guys have ever played this game or you've thought about playing it, there's a snowmobile. And I want to go play the snowmobile. Okay, so here we are. Hello. So bottles, because we can drink water. A lot of stuff you really don't need to get here. I went through and I made it all the way to the end. I mean, the game is, oh, depending on if you go through every single location. Oh, that's right, we needed to go up here to get those plants. it's, oh, I don't know, between a 6 and 10 hour experience. So it's kind of, you know, steep, but it is, of course, not in early access. It's a full release, so we don't have a lot of the bugs and all that. It's already been worked out. It was a Kickstarter game. It's in here. Toilet. Mustin, it'll be good. And I don't know, you guys probably don't want me to read all this. I don't know. Some of the stuff I will when it's smaller, but give you an idea. Basically, there aren't, by the way, no bears in the game. Never saw one at all. Okay. So, real quick, we will, before we go too much further. This is the options, and it's one of the few problems I have with the game, and I'm not quite sure what the developers were thinking, but we can go load checkpoint, main menu. If you go back to the main menu, it gives you two options, play and options. Those are the only two options it gives you, okay? Audio options, controller options, graphic options, which we'll take a quick look at. As you can see, it's not too bad. You know, a lot of things like, I always turn off motion blur. So if you have, this game runs real easy, by the way. It's not real hard on the graphics card. It does not use a lot of system memory. Something to do keep in fact, though, depending on your graphics card, you know, you can always shut things off. Personally, I did it for so long, there's certain things I just don't care for, like I don't care for bloom, motion blur, anti-aliasing. I always turn that off because it's just a pain in the butt. And I don't think it does that much. Shader quality is another big performance hitter, so you guys will want to keep your eye on that. Ambient occlusions, it's another big hit to the memory for your graphics card. So things you want to keep in mind if the game does run a little slow for you. But, and of course we can save game. So there's no exit anywhere in the games, so you can exit out. I have to alt tab out and then close the game either from my taskmaster or off my bottom hotbar. Really, devs, you guys couldn't put an exit in the game? Really? So, you know, you can exit the game if you want? Because this isn't a, the game is just long enough that you're not gonna sit for, you know, more than an hour or two, you know, so you probably got 3 or 4 sessions with the game.
Hamilton never mentioned a roadblocking barrier. Why would it be this year in the back of beyond? That would, however, be a mystery for another day. Carl had waited long enough for someone to come and raise it.
Okay. There we go. We'll turn the voice volume up. Give me a chance to keep my mouth shut in certain aspects. And then you guys can hear these. It's really weird having a voiceover talk about what you're doing through the whole game. Did find that a little weird. Interesting. Oh, nope, over here.
Still not a soul in sight. There was no point in waiting any longer. Carl had to figure this one out by himself. Hamilton is waiting for Carl in the general store.
Is he now?
It was time for him to get down to business.
Yeah, get down to business. Ain't gonna let me.
William Hamilton enjoyed a lavish country house built in the very heart of the northern forest. The populace was divided when it came to the affluent man. Some saw a wealthy philanthropist dedicated to improving the region's economy. Others an aging Englishman who would do anything to further his fortunes. And those ones hated him enough to go on about scheming against him. Hamilton had recently acquired a few local businesses, but the last straw was the reopening of a mine, which gave rise to a wave of protests and threats from the Cree people. Given these circumstances, Carl reckoned that a good number of people must be feeling compelled to oppose Hamilton in one way or another. So far, only the industrialist's house had been a target, but soon enough, Carl thought, the target.
Go hands off! So this is one of the problems that I have with the game. The loading screens are way, way too long. And you'll see as we go into different areas, the way they have the, what do you call it?
Carl needed to get out of there. The cold and the pain required urgent care.
You know what's funny is as I was doing search terms so I could try and get this out further on YouTube, because my live streams are on YouTube, guys. I used to stream on Twitch, but now I'm only streaming here on YouTube because it saves me a lot of rendering and editing time. And all you subs,
Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin stinging cold.
All of you subs, or all of my subs, I should say, are on YouTube. So, I figured I would start doing this. I've been thinking about maybe doing a little short video explaining what Indie Contact is, because it's not real difficult, you know. It's just somewhere you guys can go Monday to Friday at 1 p.m. to check out various different indie games. Sometimes we'll play a game for a couple of days. Sometimes it's just one day, like today we'll just do this once. Because it's not a very long game. It's really, it's not hard. It's not what I would call a difficult game either. So, okay. So we got that wood out front. You saw some matches. Start a fire. This is what they want you to do. And there should be a first aid kit or something around here somewhere.
Better than he had hoped. Carl Faubert had succeeded once more and was now on his way to new adventures.
Was he now? Great voice actor, whatever they have doing this. Okay, so I think we need to go up here, just like the other thing. You always, if you ever see one of these towers, you want to run to the top. It usually has goodies. They don't have that many towers, and they're not like it's a save point, but we're still hurt pretty bad. No. Okay. Interesting. I could have swore that there was the first aid kit. There was a first aid kit here. shouldn't be. It needs to be in. We need to do it in a different area. Anyway, so we got our chains. We come over here. Put them on. Alright, let's go over here.
The driver had taken off.
Yep.
It was still best to check it out and leave nothing to chance. Carl needed help.
A female. There it is, okay. So, they do everything off this radio menu. Obviously, they can use, this can easily be ported to the PlayStation or Xbox One. You got equipment, consumables, inventory, your documents, a map, and journal. So, do consumable. There we go. And I don't think I've ever seen this in a game. This is gonna hurt our health, but it raises our happiness.
Carl, like many of his contemporaries, felt like he had more trouble breathing when he wasn't smoking. Cigarette was his own personal breathing assistant.
So the other weird thing is that this game, I think it's based in the 40s or 50s. Kind of seems like it from the way the truck we're driving, and you'll see there's like no cable, no cell phones. So now, and I'm sure a lot of us, especially here in the U.S., have been playing in this kind of weather. I know I got to drive in it this year. We had some pretty fun snowfall. But that's what I like about the Pacific Northwest. You know, the weather is always changing. We get all four seasons. Whoa, unlike some that it's just one season or two. But for all you folks in those nice tropical places, give you an idea of what it's like driving here. So what we're going to do now that we're here...
Spread out on a few acres of untouched forest,
yellowing
caribou, everlasting snow...
I'm going to show you guys how to rock this first little spot, and then we're going to see if we can go get the snow working.
It was said to have been populated for millennia by Cree people, and ever since the industrial era, by the metal mining industry.
The metal mining industry.
The truck was running on fumes. Good thing that the general store was close by.
And what's... Okay, here's what I was talking about. See this? Really? This is your cutscene? I mean... If whatever audio is playing in the background, it continues it. There we go. That's just really immersion breaking. You know, you guys could have put like a little, you know, fade into a cutscene of just a snowstorm as you're waiting for it to load, then go back in. I mean, there's a lot of things they could have done other than just leave that. But, okay, so you can't put any gas in your truck until you take care of the shiz. Yeah. I think, yep. Oh, we gotta get the key first. Oh, no!
Carl had no trouble recognizing his employer. He had been killed. There was no need to be a detective to...
Oh, yeah, you gotta take pictures of stuff.
But only a detective could have noticed that the killer had to have been very close. That the fatal blow had been given before the victim even realized.
Okay.
What could be inside that envelope?
I don't know.
Carl was taken aback. He knew this address. It was said to be the address of the P.O. box for the Canadian Secret Service.
Let me... Did that sound like a gunshot? Okay, so now that we're in here... On your hot bar, you've got number one, which is our journal, and this will tell us as we go through... Who's what? A case of vandalism. And then, of course, we've got our crash. And I missed a picture already. All right. I guess you're supposed to take a picture or something? I don't know. It doesn't always give you a clue. And if it does give you a clue, it's just that little white dot, so you might miss it. And then a cold mystery. in this. There'll be more. So number two is our map. You can get nice and close to see where we are. We're right there at the general store, right? And where we're going to wind up going is going to be on. I was going to point on my monitor. That doesn't help you guys at all. Anyways, I'll show you guys on the map when we're out there. And then, of course, three is your camera. And four is a flashlight, which you'll be using a lot. So, and it's weird. Near the end of the game, they give you a portable flashlight you can carry on your chest. Why the hell didn't you do that in the first area? That is a very weird thing. So you can see we got our white dots here. Well, this place is a mess. Too many of those. Okay. Oop. Punch the price. Two numbers minimum. Sale. Turn the crank. Yep. I think we need to do that. We need to do that to get the key for the garage, I think. Okay, so it said two numbers. Oh, this does not bode well. Let me try that again. Ten. Are we missing the hand crank? No, the hand crank's in there. Let's see.
Carl knew that Gilles Lachance was in charge of the general store. That made him one of Hamilton's employees. A very angry employee, as Carl could plainly see.
Garage key, awesome. You know, I don't remember how I did this when I went through the first time. Okay. Oh, look, another key. Post key. I think that is for a clue, but anyways, go through, hit all our drawers real quick here. Nope, what do we got here? Ha-ha! Now you need
According
this.
According to that log, it seemed like the whole village owed some money to the general store. Carl was far more interested in the bunch of nearby addresses he had just gotten his hands on, though.
So now you can see we have all of the things that we need, all the different places to go and check out the story. Oops. Okay. And let's see, we'll move the ladder. No point in turning the pump on until we come over here. I'll show you what's on up at that ladder here in a second. You guys will see there is a point. Okay, turn on switch. From generator. So now we might have to go. I think we gotta go outside and try and fix it. So both those are on.
Maintaining his composure, Carl recalled something from his military training. Wolves always stay away from populated areas. Wait, was it about bears? Carl was no electrician, but he could identify a wiring problem when he saw one.
All right, where are those tools at? that's what we're looking for. And we will be coming back to this area because we're going to grab that crowbar. And again, it's... So you guys, because you get a crowbar, an axe, and... Crowbar, axe... Oh, and one other thing. Hammer. Anyways. Alright. So, to fill up your truck... You can only have the garage on at one time. Oops. Go. And now... Oh, shut the hell up. You come over here. Turn on pump number two. For that, crank and go up here. Should be, this dude should have some... Boom. Sherry wine. We're going to need that for what I'm going to show you guys next. Because I'm going to do my best to show you guys how to get the winter coat. If we can do it fast enough here. But what you want to do, though, is tune in. I'll be making a video besides this live stream. And I'll go in.
Given the circumstances... Oops. Leaving with an empty tank would be a death warrant. Carl had to refuel.
And that's the fastest refueling you're ever gonna see. Alright, so
Carl
that's done.
Carl knew straight away where to find the infuriated Gelachin. Any good investigation would have to start there.
Oh!
The murder weapon. What was that doing there, Carl wondered. Hamilton must have been determined to keep some information secret to post this key. Shame he got unlucky. Everything made sense now. Poor Hamilton's denunciation was interrupted, and he figured it would be best to lock everything up and send the key to his correspondent, who would receive the box later on. Clever, but not enough. That's what happens to ordinary people playing spy.
There we go. And now we get
at
our first
last,
weapon.
The crowbar was within Carl's grasp. Surely it would come in handy at some point.
Yeah, you need it to pry open stones to get talismans, which I don't understand why they did, because they don't affect the end of the game at all. There we go. Now I'm going to show you guys what to go next. If you do what I'm doing here, it's just a real fast way. So then you don't have to worry about dealing with always having to make fires.
Carl felt that the store and its surroundings still held
their... So you want to go here to the left.
And he didn't like to miss out.
Watch out, another massive loading screen coming up. Here we go. So we're going to want to go past the first house and that station. Come back. That's normally where you go get your winter coat, but he says, I want you to make me this special booze. So, we're going to go up, and I'm going to make that special booze. To tell you, I don't know. Let's make sure I didn't go. Where am I? Oh, actually, yeah. Look, we just went past it. Damn it. Rearview mirror don't work. Okay, there we go. Right into a frozen screen. Like I said, it breaks the immersion, but, you know. Oh! But, you know, that doesn't bother you. The game is a lot of fun. I mean, it'll keep you going from thing to thing to thing to thing.
House of the Patriots.
As always, if you guys have any questions,
the place
throw
looked more
them
like
up
a pigsty than a house. A heavy stench of curdled milk, cheap alcohol, and boiled cauliflower filled the air.
Ooh.
Back then, in Africa and elsewhere, people were ready to take up arms to stand against the yoke of English imperialism. In Montreal, mailboxes were blown up, abductions were carried out, and violent manifestos were distributed to media outlets. But around here, in the great northernmost, all a man could do is curse out loud against a faraway evil and pray for the revolution to arise. That man, by any reckoning, was from that very stock. Ré Jean Blouin. Seems like that pig had a name after all.
Obviously, he doesn't like him. See, and you go through, you look around, there's a bunch of things. Mostly empty. But each place has its own little, you know, stuff to explore, which is cool. Kind of prerequisite if you're, you know, like me and you're a loot whore and you love doing that stuff. Okay, so, here we go.
Carl figured this recipe wasn't meant to yield a refined nectar.
Now, I do have an empty bottle on me. You need to have an empty bottle and that sherry wine. And now we have the caribou. We can go get our jackets so we don't have to freeze our butt off the whole time while we're doing this.
You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death.
All right. So let's go get our winter jacket, and then we'll see about getting over to where the snowmobile is. And if we don't finish, I will show probably in my impressions video how to do it, how to get the snowmobile, because it's you can drive just about everywhere.
Carl held in his hand some awful sugar alcohol.
And it'll save you a lot of time.
But rather than drink it, he told himself it could be useful. He only had to be wary.
Now, I am bypassing parts of the story on purpose. So if you guys are wondering, I said I'm just going to try and show you guys. So if you want to pick up the game, and hopefully you do, give you an idea of where you're supposed to go. That's where I want to go. This is where you'll meet one of the very, very few NPCs. Oop. Here we go. Just 'cause. curious my second time through if they're random generated things or if they're always there. Hi!
Oh, mon bonhomme! Je m'attendais pas à ce qu'un étrange retentisse par ici. Moi te dire, je prends plus de chance depuis que ça rôde dans ce bout-là. J'ai ma carabine au bout du doigt, et puis bang, 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 si ça s'approche!
Want that jacket?
Si tu veux du linge chaud, parce que t'es habillé comme un gars de la ville, je dirais pas non à une bonne bouteille de caribou.
There
puis
we go.
Puis tu pigeras ce que tu voudras parmi mes guenilles.
Oh, quand on cherche, on trouve. Parce que je t'aime bien, Aster, je vais te dire quelque chose. Tu fais bien de prendre ma pénisse. Parce que par là-bas, tu vas rencontrer le vrai froid. Un froid qui glace comme t'en as jamais connu dans ta vie.
So before we put it on, see, I got a leather jacket, jeans, tennis shoes. Damn, full outfit.
Totally geared up.
Geared out. Take that.
C'est encore beau. Tout ce qui est vieilli est bien meilleur.
So now we should not have to worry about the cold anywhere as much as we did before. But it's still a good idea. Let's see, inventory. One long match, plenty of matches. What about the fire starter? Ooh, that's a, oh, we got two of those. So we'll keep our eyes open for more fire starters. And then you don't need any more of the fire making materials once you get the jacket like I'm in now. So some areas it's just gonna make you cold, and that's just the way it works. Oh, wait a minute, we need to get the key out of here. There should be a key.
Dans mon temps, c'était comme sur l'image. On était vrai, fier, fort, puis on avait le bon lieu de notre bord. Hé, la Corriveau, Batèche, ça te passe l'envie de te marier, la Corriveau. Elle tuait tous ses maris, squeak, les uns après les autres. Pas de pitié dans le mariage.
Hop.
Ben oui, une couche. Tu peux-tu tout faire en même temps, toi?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I can do everything at the same time. Okay, where in the hell is that stupid key that's supposed to be in here?
Mon beau bonnet du beau temps. Puis ma ceinture, où est-ce que je glissais mon flasque.
Yes.
Le monde tournait plus rond quand on s'habillait tout de même. Tiens donc, ça ouvre la pantille. Prends-la, je m'en fous.
Okay. All right. And the reason we come in here isn't for that, it is for the gas tank. You're gonna need that so that you can, put gas in the snowmobile. That's the only reason. There, and what's interesting is the game.
What mattered most. And the old man's quote made sure of that. However, Carl still felt that he would miss out on precious knowledge if he left this place.
Yeah, see, I didn't do everything there. And I'm not going to, like I said, I'm trying to just, we're just gonna see if we should be able to get to the, easily do the snow stuff now. Whoa. Stupid and look at our map while we're driving. All right. And being real nosy is good in this game. Some of the mirror boxes have stuff in them. That's the spark plug that we need. And you'll see these wolf tracks. You're going to see them a lot. They're what we would follow if, as you're going through the store and everything, following the wolf tracks will take you out and show you various different things, story related. So, to get everything that we need, first things first, we'll get one of the tracks out of there.
What good was a motorless car? The mechanic sure had an odd way to go about repairing things.
Interesting you can't even open this one. Okay, so next, there's the other track. And I don't remember if there was anything in here, so we'll do a quick run by. Complaint, I'm afraid.
Roswell. Atamipek. Same story. Large deserts conducive to extravagant follies.
So the fun thing is the game does eventually go dark on you, and I had to do this whole area in the dark. You want to talk about a pain in the butt. Dang, those are random. Oh no, he wears the old tin hat. One of the Roswell believers.
These scribblings were undoubtedly the mark of a tormented mind. Something wasn't right in the poor mechanic's head.
Okay, well. Maybe that's it. Okay, so. Let's turn that off. Alright, so the other things. Painkillers. I don't remember if there's something in here, but.
The very first steps of man on the moon were made more than a year ago. The event had surely captivated the mechanic's mind for him to still keep this around.
Ah, yes, headlight. We need that.
Week of October 5th, thought Carl. That was this week. The plug should have been here by now. The man seemed petrified.
You know, I shouldn't be cold at all.
What Carl saw terrified him, and he didn't know if it was the fear or the cold that was responsible for his hair standing on end all over his body. The poor man, before being frozen solid, seemed to be defending the entrance to his cabin. But from what?
I know. Okay, so let's see if we found what we need.
By following the plan, Carl was led to believe that the snowmobile's parts had to be scattered about in the vicinity.
Okay, we're missing the damn handlebars. Uh, That's the sea cushion. We'll find them. I think they're they've got to be around here somewhere. The track is right over here. I think it's in here somewhere. Yep, there it is. That's what I missed. Alright, so before we do that, the other thing we're going to need to do is fill up our gas can. Alright, now we're good. I think we are. Put the skis on.
A bit of gas, a new spark plug, and the key. And this thing would run perfectly. All he needed to do now was to find all that.
I know where the key is. So, every time you see one of these little things right here, it tells you to whip out your camera.
The Polaroid. Carl's long-standing and faithful ally has seen a share of husbands caught red-handed cheating. There's always something out there waiting to be snapped away.
So, also, whenever you head out into these areas, make sure that you have either the crowbar, axe, or hammer in hand, because we gotta fight wolves. Now, there is a rifle around
Carl
here.
Carl hadn't lived up to his good fighting.
I just don't remember where it was. It's on this side of the map.
Any of the wealth contained in Lamotte's lands.
See, there's a puppy up there we're going to have to fight. So if you don't get the snowmobile, this is a lot of what you do around the cabins. Following the tracks to get anywhere, to get to the next little clue section. So, hey, bad puppy.
Carl never thought he would be dancing with the wolves.
So, not real complicated combat. Obviously not the focus of the game. Also, again, whenever you see these, you want to take the camera out. Oop. Picture. Really? They're going to throw that one away? Because I thought we want to keep. This is there we go. That's a key point to the game. Ah, yes. This is the other reason you need the crowbar. To get to the thing here we're going to do. And it's another puzzle. Maybe I'll remember. Oh God, I hope I can freaking remember how to do it.
The secret project.
That large antenna in the middle of the path. Undoubtedly ideal in attempting to communicate with little green men. Was quite awkwardly placed. There had to be a lever to control it. Maybe behind it. Carl would have to figure out how to reach it.
It's very easy to reach. I know, it's kind of weird. It's like the game will talk to you and hold your hand in some aspects, like you have no idea what you're doing if you're a gamer. And that's cool to a certain extent. Oh, I went too far. Because that way, you know, a lot of people that maybe aren't into games, it can help them to get into games. But, I mean, I can see how they could even port this easily to iOS. It's not what you would call difficult when it comes to these things. So, when it comes to controlling aspect, I mean, it's pretty easy first-person perspective. Interesting. that I can now go up and go around over here. I can do that before. Anyways.
The electric terminals appear to be linked together, but for what purpose?
Okay. So the negative is supposed to be towards the blue, I think. There. See, I knew I'd forget. And it took me a while to figure this puzzle out. So I guess we'll go blue to that color. Because if you follow... Yeah, blue. So what connects... Oh, okay, I get it. So what connects these guys is a positive... So those now should be connected, and what connects these two? The red line.
So that's where the generator key was hiding. All that was left was to use it.
What the hell? Okay, so maybe turn the positive? Not we have a positive and a negative, right? Isn't that the way it's supposed to work? You have one side positive, one side negative. So... That one there. There's a nice blue one where it goes. Right. So we got a positive and a negative. See, this is a weird thing, right? So, I figured we can jump it, you know, if it's got the two cables coming and going out, put them together. No. 6 years. red one is the one that actually comes for this connector. Right. No, the red is disconnected. That blue line ends. That line terminates there, so put a negative. Still not working. Oh. See, it doesn't give you any. I'm not seeing any visual cues here as to where we should put this to. So it's not all negative, it's not all positive. I knew I should wrote this down how I figured it out before, because like I said, it took me like an hour to do. But let's see, so that side goes there. Where is this other blue side? And the blue side just goes right here. This is what I don't get. Is it negative to negative? Normally that's okay, that's right. Negative, negative, positive to negative. Is that negative, negative? Does that mean this one would be positive? So does that mean the other two need to be positive? But it ends in a termination. So, in theory, if this has to be negative, that's positive. God, how confusing. Ooh, doggy. Looks like the red actually was what connects in here. Oh, okay, so it's a positive. So that means he's got, this probably has to be a positive. Nope. It does not give two shits. That's supposed to be a negative to the green. Right. Nope, that one's hanging. Oh, God. So which one is freaking connected over here to the not to do wrong. Positive, positive, right. This one gets connected over here. So we got that green line. Where's that green line go? Instant connects, death. Yellow one. Really, the red connects to that one. So is there a that's the thing, is there a connection to this one? It looks like it's the blue. And you can't do it. It would have to be the orange, and the orange is not happening. So the red. Connect here.
Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
As long as it takes me to figure out this stupid thing. Oh, well. You know, folks, the easiest way to fix this last part is just go on YouTube, look for Kona/snowmobile, and I'm sure you can find it, or snowmobile key, because that's what this is, snowmobile key. So I'd like to thank you for watching today. Remember, every Monday through Friday at 1 o'clock, I'm going to have some kind of an indie goodie game for you. So you always want to tune in, like, favorite, and subscribe on my channel. Remember, I am doing this now on YouTube instead of Twitch. So if you want to come in, you want to help support my channel, especially with all the craziness going on with AdSense, hit that super chat. Or you can buy one of my shirts. I have links, of course, in the description below. So please, come back and join me on Monday at 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, which is what I'm doing here. And as always, keep your heads down, your guns up, and I'll see you again real damn soon.